For years, 64-year-old Judith Martin, a diabetic and cancer survivor, struggled to pay her health insurance premiums.
It was almost $900 a month. Well, there was just no way I could do that.
A former school teacher, Martin resorted to using free clinics before Massachusetts passed its landmark health insurance reform in 2006. The plan, known as Commonwealth Care, mandates that every resident have health insurance. Those who can't afford it, like Martin, are subsidized, which means she now pays $176 a month, $700 less than before.
It's a very safe feeling. I feel protected.
3 years into the program, Massachusetts has the lowest percentage of uninsured in the country, 2.6%, compared to the national average of 16%.
Okay, no female throughput.
But the success hasn't been cheap. In its first year, the plan cost $133 million, 17% under budget. Last year, costs rose to $628 million, 33% over budget, as the economy faltered and thousands of laid-off workers signed up for the program. This year and next, Commonwealth Care is expected to cost more than $800 million.
Critics are saying this is costing too much money. Spending has spiraled out of control. Is that true or not?
It's really not true.
Economist Jonathan Gruber helped create the Massachusetts plan and has advised President Obama on national health reform.
This was never designed to be a bill that would fundamentally rein in the cost of health care in Massachusetts. This was designed to be a bill to say, look, we have the resources in Massachusetts to cover all the uninsured by rededicating spending we were already doing as a state. And we did that.
Gruber says the next challenge is to contain health care costs, now growing 6% a year nationally. Massachusetts spends almost $7,000 per person on health care, the most of any state in the country.
Now, Massachusetts is focusing on bringing down those costs. Its first step is an attempt to completely change how doctors get paid.
Those savings would come through a proposed global payment system, which would give doctors a lump sum of money for all of a patient's care, instead of paying a fee for each test and office visit, an approach meant to promote preventive care.
Right now, we spend about $1 billion for hospitalizations that we don't think need to happen, for emergency visits, emergency room visits, for care that could be otherwise provided in a lower cost setting in a physician's office.
In Massachusetts, the investment is beginning to pay off. Of the 600,000 people who lacked health insurance 3 years ago, 430,000 are now covered, and many at risk of losing their care are able to afford it. When Martin had surgery for uterine cancer last year, it cost her only a $200 deductible.
I don't think I'm overstating it when I say how much I appreciate them and they saved my life.
And she's glad she lives in Massachusetts. Priya David, CBS News, Worcester, Massachusetts.